right, suck in your gut, Cairo, because I'm just about to tell the cheeseoids how great you are and what a cherished guest you are on the show. Cairo, Jim, it's good to see you again.
Thank you, Ryan. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah, listen, now we're talking about the Marvels. Why don't you recap and tell the cheeseoids all about the Marvels?
Well, as I said before, in case you weren't watching, the marbles came from the Parthenon, beautiful building in Athens. And there was an Englishman there, Lord Elgin, and here's some of the marbles now behind Karen. This is what they look like. They're in the British Museum now because Lord Elgin took them from Greece. He got the permission from the invaders. They had no right to be there. They gave him permission to take these things.
I see.
Now, I think that what he did at the time was a good thing.
Old Lord Audubon there.
In 1800, when he did this, Lord Elgin, when he did it, it was a good thing. The reason is, shortly after he took those away, see, the invading army was using the Parthenon as a storeroom for explosives, gunpowder, for cannons, and some idiot was smoking, I think. And
well,
they threw
it to be.
Well, yes, they could smoke. They threw a match in, and poof! The whole roof went off.
It would have been more than a poof, I tell you that.
It was a big explosion. It was huge. The roof was blown off the Parthenon. And if those beautiful marbles, those marble statues, had still been there, they would have been destroyed completely. Yeah. So he did the right thing,
so
taking them away.
He unwittingly salvaged some great piece of Athenian art, basically.
He did. But I think that now they should be returned because the Greek government are asking for the marbles to be returned to Greece because they belong to Greece.
Well, that's what you think.
What do you think,
cheeseoids? We want you to decide for yourselves what we should do. Should we keep them in Britain or should we keep them in, or send them back to Greece, yes?
That's right. If you agree with me, with Cairo Jim, why don't you draw a picture of the Parthenon or the marbles or write me a short letter, a note, and send it to this address. Cairo Jim has lost his marbles.
P.O. Box 606 Broadway 2007 is that address.
That's the address. And I personally will gather up all the mail that you send. You know, take your time, make it great. I will gather it up and I will personally take it to the Australian committee that's been set up to get the marbles returned to Greece.
Send in your verdict, cheese. But right now we're going to one of our spectacular cartoons, Dragon Ball Z. Here it is.
Come on, heel. Bitch, come on, I'll pass you a ball and you just... What's the square root of 49, eh? Hey!
Hey! Hey, Harry!
Hey.
Harry, what are you doing, man?
Look, you know, Jay, I just can't get over the fact that my little old dog Percy left me for another master.
Oh, come on, mate. Percy will come back one day.
Really?
Yes!
Really?
In the meantime, I reckon I got something to cheer you up.
Percy!
Whoa! Pretty rough.
Mate, how are ya? I'm pretty hoping good. You can cheer me up. You're Simon, horse trainer?
Yeah, horse trainer,
mate,
that's
it's
right.
Great to see you. Look, I've had a little problem with my dog, okay? He's ran away and I'm... Now, I'm sorry, I've just noticed something. No due respect here, but what is that? That's a dog, that's not a horse, and you're a horse trainer.
Sure is, that's right. His name's Solomon, and he's always with me when I'm training my horses.
Oh, well isn't that sweet? He's kind of your lassie, your counterpart, yeah?
That's
like
exactly
I am,
right.
Jade, you got
that's
a,
exactly
you got a
right.
dog. Oh, that's great. Can he do any, you know, tricks?
Yeah, he can do a couple of tricks, he might do a few now.
Alright, he might do. Good stuff. Come on, bring him on up. Come on, you little beauty. Now, what is he actually going to do here,
Sam? He's going to get on his back legs. Begin to walk.
He can walk! He can walk! Oh, my dear. Percy, you're going out with a dodo, my friend. You are the help of my dreams. Give me, you little thing. When did you last bathe him?
Probably 1 hour ago.
1 hour ago.
Just for the show.
Okay. Well, it might need a minute routine next time, you know, with the stench and all.
Yeah, you have to do it.
How long have you had old Solomon, eh?
I've had him for approximately 6 years.
6 years?
Yep.
Really? And how old is he?
He's about 7.
Wow, that's fantastic. And why did you decide to train a dog and not a horse?
Well, I saw him sitting there. I had him for so long and I thought, it's a shame not to do anything
because
with him,
there
so
is
I might
an obvious
well do
difference.
Something.
Yes. Well, it was lovely talking to you. There's going to be more questions thrown into your face right after this. It's Pokemon.
Thanks, Harry.
Do the next case. He's not as good.
Hey, Solomon, the wonder dog, how you going? And this is Simon, the horse trainer. How are you, Simon?
I'm not bad. Yourself?
I'm very well. Now, why do you train horses?
Train horses because it's good fun.
Yeah.
And not bad money too.
Oh, all right. And what do people have you train their horses for?
I actually break them in for people.
Right.
So usually the horse has never been ridden before.
Yeah.
And so I make it safe.
A wild Brumby, hey?
Well, yeah, sometimes, but yeah. Not often. Usually just horses that people have had for a few years, but they've never just ridden them, that's all, so.
Right, what do people have horses for anyway? I mean,
all styles of things. Sometimes just a pleasure.
Yeah.
And other times I'd like to do jumping or dressage or, you know, racing.
Right. Now what you do with animals is really a great thing because, I mean, I've got a couple of dogs at home and they have no discipline. They're wild dogs, but look at Solomon here. He's so well behaved. I mean, I'm just walking around the set here. I mean, he's going everywhere. You're going in the basement.
That's right. That's right.
I mean, how do you talk to these wild animals?
Well, he follows me because we always have good times.
You have a good time.
That's where we're going, there's going to be some action.
How do you talk to the animals on their level? You don't know their language, I mean, it's crazy.
You got to somehow, with a dog, I like to somehow trick them into doing something. If you want him to go and fetch an object for you, you start off with playing with a ball or something like that, and you throw it, you get him to chase the ball, he gets excited, you know. You then change that ball into something else, and eventually you can just say, hey, go and get it.
Go and grab that.
He brings it back.
No, ball to a newspaper.
That's right, exactly.
I like
that. He can get it out of the letterbox for you.
Yeah. I like that, Simon. Now,
like he does.
Let's have Sol have a trick for us. He goes to the letterbox every morning.
He sure does, every morning.
Done the post run this morning.
Never get dumped through the hoop.
He dropped off my Manly Daily.
Yeah!
Whoa, there it is, Sol! What a great trick, and he's off. He's gone off to, he's wrecking up Good Morning Australia set. That's very bad, Solomon. We're fine.
Stand by, Cheezoids. It's time for this week's lucky winners in the Yogo Stereo promotion. You've won a fantastic stereo, which has a CD player, tape deck, and AM/FM radio. Congratulations, and keep watching at this time every week for more stereo winners. But now it's back over to Jade and Ryan and CheezTV.
Welcome back. You're watching CheezTV. It's Friday. Ryan,
you can smell it. Smell that Friday.
Smell it. It's lovely. How are you, Mark?
Pretty good. You got any lettuce for me? I've
been
red lettuce for a while.
We're looking to get through as many as we can today, so let's get cracking.
Let's go like blue blazers.
Listening, Mark, eh?
Blue blazers?
Listen to this. Jujia CheezTV, I love Pokemon. My favourite Pokemon is Pikachu. What happened to Inspector Gadget? I like that as well. Mm. Odds are it will probably come back as a classic, yes? Mm. Not as a repeat, but a classic.
Classic, jeez.
They're sending some wonderful pictures here. Thank you very much, guys. Wonderful, wonderful.
Wow, we've got some great things here to put on your door from Matthew. He sent us. Dear CheezTV, hi, my name's Matthew Hasdesky. I'm 11 years old and I watch your show all the time. I think it's the best in the universe. Hey, my favourite cartoons are the Pokemon and Dragon Ball Z. Hope you like the pictures we laid for you. We're loving Matthew. Check that one out as well.
Oh, Matthew. Matthew.
That's mean. That's Mewtwo. Get down.
Mewtwo.
Yeah.
Alright, well, it's funny that you talk about Mew because here is Pokemon.
Me neither.
I reckon we should really workshop these letters and get them as good as we can.
We should get through as many as we can. Welcome back. You're watching CheezTV. It's Friday and we're joined by Mark the Sound Man.
Hey, fellas.
How are you, Mark, this morning?
We got some nice letters there today because you know what? Reading letters is good practice for reading books, and you should read books because one day it'll save your life.
It will.
It will.
The Gatsby told me that.
That's right. Hmm? Books will save your life. Yep. You know, this is like some quirky thing that'll come back to me in years to come. I don't want to go into it, but we should read some letters.
All right. I think
we shall. A little bit of practice. Here you go.
Okay. Dear Jade and... Is that Ryan?
That's Ryan. You're doing good, mate. You're doing good.
My two sons, Sam and Seb...
That's good.
Love watching your TV show. They have worked very hard producing these words... Pictures
this gag
of their
ain't going nowhere,
Pokemon.
Pal.
Come on,
in fact,
Lepo.
They are Pokemon crazy. Well, how unique. Yours sincerely, Sally, their mum. These are absolutely wonderful pictures as well. We love them. Thank you very much.
Sam and Sid, thank you very much, guys.
Look at this one. Lovely pencil sketch.
And mum too, don't forget
and
Sally.
And mum too.
Good on you, Sal.
See, Mark, always thinking of the mums. Hey, it's time for Dragon Ball Z! Welcome, Mark. back. You're watching Cheese TV, and please make a welcome to the Cheese Team. She's our new regular games reviewer, Marie. How you going?
I'm going well. How are you?
Yeah. Oh, I'm fantastic.
Excellent.
Welcome to Cheese TV.
Thank you.
We're glad to have you on board.
I'm glad to be on board.
It's glad to meet you.
Thank you.
It's great. Hey, we better move on. What game are you reviewing today?
Well, the first thing I'm going to review isn't actually a game, but it's just as fun as a game, and that's Encarta. Do you want to know what Encarta is?
Tell us about it.
Encarta is an encyclopedia, right? But it's not a big, chunky book of words you don't understand.
Sure.
You go in, you put in your search, and it comes up fun, easy to understand information, perfect for learning, perfect for your assignments. It's really, really good. It's high in Australian content, which is good because if you're doing an assignment, say, on an Australian animal or an Australian, you know, discoverer, he's more than likely going to be in this because it does have high Australian content.
Sure. Whereas if you're looking at an American one,
you're not going to find as much on Australia.
They wouldn't have cook, they wouldn't have wombat. All the stuff we like.
That's right. All the stuff we love.
Right. That's very nice, Marie. And what would you give it out of one out of ten?
I'd give it a 9 only because it's fun and you're going to love using it.
Very nice. And Maria, great game for you. I'll give you a 10 out of 10 for that review. That was fantastic. What are we looking at now?
Well, after you've done your homework and you've done all your studying, we've got a game for you. Now, not just any game, Donkey Kong.
Oh.
So pull out your Nintendo. Let me tell you about Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong is a game where you have to destroy these creatures, right? You have to get them before they get you. So what you're doing is you're grabbing these barrels with fire and you're throwing it at the fire at these creatures before they spit fire at you.
Whoa!
Right. So then, like, once you've done that, there's another stage, right, where you're sitting in this little carriage and you're grabbing for money left, right and centre, right, and there are all these coins. But there are also creatures trying to smack you to get your coins, right? Because they don't want you to have money. They want the money for themselves,
They
right?
want the money themselves.
That's right. So that's what you've got to try and do, just avoid these
right.
creatures.
Now, what about the gameplay? It goes nice on the N64, does it?
Very nice. Goes very well. Only thing is, it is very fast-paced. So, I don't know. Because there is a lot of destroying animals and stuff, I'd probably say for kids, be over 6.
Be over six. There you have it. We take the hard line here at Cheese. You've got to be over 6 for this heavy game. But thank you very much, Marie. She'll be back. We'll be back. It's all fun. And right now, it's time for the Pokemon. You're going to love it. We love you. It's great to have you here. Ah!
If you change your mind, I'm the first in line.
I am not blonde.
You are
blonde. Oh, hey, welcome back, Cheese. You know, the word that's on everyone's mind at the moment is snap. And we have a very special guest in today who's actually going to be your games review regular. And it's Marie.
It's
how are you doing, Marie?
Hi, how are you doing?
You know, it is really great to have you on the show.
Thank you. It's really great to be here.
Yeah, because, you know, we don't really get often any professionals on the show.
I am a professional.
So please take it away. Tell us about Pokemon Snap.
Well, being a professional in Pokemon, guys, I have to tell you about Pokemon Snap. So what you're doing is you put on an island by Professor Oak, right? Professor Oak is a professor.
Of course.
He's putting together a report on Pokemons, right? So he's given you a camera, really nifty camera, and a vehicle called 01. And what you do is you get in this vehicle, right?
Yeah.
And you drive through a beach or an island or whatever course you choose.
Yeah.
And you have to find the Pokemons, take a photo of it, collect them, save them or whatever, and take them back to Professor Oak, who puts it in his report. So you're probably thinking, okay, so what do you do? Well, you do get points on how good your photo is, what kind of Pokemon it is.
So he decides which are the best ones, basically.
Yeah, well, we decide, and then he gets to put them in his report, if he likes it, but
right.
you get rated on it.
Okay, and speaking of rating, what rating would you give it out of 10?
I'd give it a 7 out of 10.
Yeah.
It is slow-moving, guys, so if you're a bit older, you might not enjoy it, but it's great for learning about Pokemons.
All right, okay, now that is slow-moving. What is fast-moving? Give us something that's really...
Very fast-moving. Super Smash Brothers. Smash Brothers, yeah, it's really, really cool. You've got your favourite Nintendo characters put in the one game. So you've got Pikachu, you've got Donkey Kong, you've
Luigi.
Got... No, you've got his cousin, Super Mario, but I mean, he's cool.
Super.
And what you do is you put on this environment, say you're on a mini island, but it's all air around it, and you're just going to push these characters out of the way. It's a really, really cool game.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, and what would you give that out of 10, do you think?
I'd give it an 8. Very cool game.
Oh, really? You like that?
Great graphics.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you to Marie, and right now it's
Thanks,
over
guys.
To Dragon Ball Z. Marie.
See ya.